there's coming a time on the great judgment morning when the Savior will welcome you home. Will you be prepared for the journey to heaven on the great ship that carried God's chosen ones home?
The water so deep
on the river of Jordan,
on the river of Jordan,
and the light shines so bright,
and the light shines so bright from heaven above,
from heaven above,
and the midnight is past.
The great ship will anchor
in the harbor of love.
If you're wandering in sin, away from God's teaching, won't you ask Him to show you the way? Fall down on your knees in the chapel next Sunday and meet all your friends up in heaven someday.
Oh, the water's so deep.
Oh, the water's so deep
on the river of Jordan.
On the river of Jordan.
And the light shines so bright.
And the light shines so bright from heaven.
The great ship will anchor in the harbor of love.
Hey everybody, Becky Buller here, baking a cookie. I'm going to sing you a song in memory of Dave Hagar Nelson. He was famous for Hagar's Half Pounder cookies. He was from up in Wisconsin, and we're gonna just miss him a whole lot. He was a great guy.
I believe my steps are growing wearier each day. Still I've got another journey on my mind. The lures of this old world have ceased to make me wanna stay. And my one regret is leaving you behind. But if it proves to be His will that I am first to go, then somehow I've a feeling it will be. When it comes your time to travel likewise, don't feel lost, for I will be the first one that you see. Hagar's waiting on the far side banks of Jordan. He's waiting, playing doghouse in the band. And when he sees us coming, he'll rise up with a shout and come running with a bag of half-pound cookies in his hand. See, it's for cookie, that's good enough for me. See, it's for cookie, that's good enough for me. See, it's for cookie, that's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C.
I met Hagar back when I was in high school, going to those bluegrass festivals up in Minnesota, Wisconsin. And there it was many a time that one of those half-pound cookies and an RC Cola sustained me after a long late-night jam session. Hagar was a great friend to bluegrass music, me and so many other people, and we're going to miss him a whole lot. So God bless and rest you, Hagar. We'll never forget you.
This is Little Roy Lewis.
And I'm Lizzie. We're the Little Roy and Lizzie Show. We just got done playing here in Connecticut, so we're all hot and sweaty and rough looking. But we wanted to put our part in for remembering Hagar Nelson. He was a great friend of ours, and you know, everybody known him for the half pound cookie. And when I was a little girl with the Lewis family, the first time I ever met him, he brought a big old cardboard box of half pound cookies. It had M&M's and chocolate chips. Do you remember that?
I remember that, and I remember one story that I told about a bear or something, a dog swallowed a bear. He never let me forget that story the rest of my life. I never told it but one time, but he never let me forget it.
No.
I was wanting to say to the family, we're so sorry. We're going to miss him. We're going to miss that kind big man that made the good cookies.
Yeah, we all will. We love you, Hagar, and the family and friends. We love you too, and we're sorry for your loss.
Honey, we met Hagar at one of the festivals
in Wisconsin.
And he was so sweet and gracious, and he gave us t-shirts that we still wear. Rick wears his big half-pound cookie t-shirt all the time.
He gave us whole bags of cookies
that were good. I'm not even a sweet eater, and you have to do a powerful lot of eating to get through one of the cookies, but they were good. And he will be missed. He was a true friend of bluegrass music.
He will be missed.
Hey everybody, this is Steve Dillon.
And this is Skip Cherry Holmes here.
And we're here just to reflect a minute or so about our time for old buddy Hagar. Of course, he was famous for his half-pound cookies. So I don't know if they were always a half. Seemed like they were a pound sometimes.
Yeah, big old thing.
Yeah, but what a guy. I guess one of my favorite things about Hagar was his spirit. He was always a happy guy. Seemed like he was always happy to be at a bluegrass festival, and he always came by, and whether he was bringing you a cookie or a t-shirt or both, he always had a smile on his face and a lot of positive comments, and he will definitely be missed. I hate to, Skip and I have talked about Hagar with the guys in sideline, and hate they didn't ever get a chance to meet him, but we just certainly hate that he's gone, but he will always be around in spirit, and appreciate our time that we got to spend with him.
Yeah, I remember one specific kind of interesting thing that happened with him. My family played up at the Big Top Chautauqua. It was a great big circus tent style concert, and we'd already done sound check and ate and everything, getting ready to go on, and a humongous storm blew through and knocked the power out for the whole park. And Hagar, a couple other people too, Hagar went, he pulled his car around to where his headlights were shining out on the stage, and they lit up the stage. That way we played an acoustic set with just headlights from cars.
Oh,
and it was just a real intimate and really cool setting that I remember him being a part of, and so that was always a fond memory of mine.
That's the way he was. He was always willing to help no matter what it was needed. So God bless you, brother.
Hi, this is Danny Paisley. You know, first time I met Hagar, we were playing a school up in above Milwaukee, and this old big old bearded fella come strolling up to the record table with a bag full of cookies. And I said, oh, great, man, thank you. And we sat down, and I took one look down inside that bag thinking I'm going to get a cookie out before we get ready to play. And the darn thing was a half a pound. I said, good googamooga. And we laughed, and I nibbled on it a little bit. I thought, good grief, it's good. And so we played our set and got done, and he bought some CDs, and I didn't have any $5 bills because we sold them for $15. And he said, you need some? And I said, yeah. So I bought like 10 of them off of him. Then about that following June, we're down at Bean Blossom. Here he comes again, and I remembered him with the cookies, you know, bringing me a T-shirt and a pocket full of $5 bills. So we bought them. We sat there and talked all afternoon between racing, bluegrass music, and just different things in life. And from then, we just had a good friendship. And that's what you do in life. You just make a friend like that. He sticks with you. He loves the music. Hagar loved racing. He loved people. And that's what we'll all remember about him. Thank you.
Hey, friends. This is Ernie Evans coming to you live from sunny Florida. Thought I'd take a minute out of the studio to talk to you folks a little bit. If you're hearing my voice right now, there's a good chance that bluegrass is what's brought us together, but probably even better chance that our good pal Hagar is who brought us together. I remember I was 12 years old going to my first bluegrass festival and having such a good time there that I knew I wanted to do this for the rest of my life. And I could tell you that one of the biggest contributors there was probably some of the artists that were there. But let's not forget the people who make bluegrass, because I had the most fun, I think, growing up in this music off stage than I have on stage. And folks like Hagar made being off stage special. Sure look forward to him. I know there's lots of talk. I won't get into the cookie thing because it was a treat for me as well. And somebody's got to get that recipe. Melissa, I'm going to nominate you for that and to take over there. So get your apron on and we'll see you soon. But anyway, I do want to say hey to everybody. And again, he's surely going to be missed. And I know that they just don't make people like that. My heroes, my musical heroes, are what got me through the gate at a bluegrass festival. But guys like Hagar, what kept me coming back. Now, in honor of Hagar, I'm wearing my East Troy shirt. It's probably backwards on there, but you can see that. It's my favorite shirt. I wear it quite a bit, and I need a new one. But anyway, once again, thank you all so much for making his life special, too, because he knew he was loved by all you folks out there. That's why he gave it back. He's one of those guys that we all wish we could be like. And we could take a page out of his book and treat others that way. I'm going to try hard. Hagar, thanks so much. It's an honor to be one of your friends. I know you had many, but just to be one of those that was in there was a true honor for me. Thanks so much. You all have a great day. And remember, Hagar, every time you get to a bluegrass festival or you go out in the general public and you look at somebody and have an interaction with them, what would Hagar say?
The first place I met Hagar was at IBMA, like everybody else, and he was roaming the halls, of course, giving away his free cookies that later on I found out were quite expensive for him to make. First of all, they were chock full of walnuts, and you know how expensive walnuts are. But anyway, winter before last, we had a string of gigs in Wisconsin, and we're at a small town in Wisconsin, and we had a little pickup gig, and we didn't have a lot of time to publicize it, so not many people showed up, except for Hagar. He said, this is my neighborhood, and all evening he sat there and listened to the music, and during the break we sat down and had a really nice chat, and he was telling me about his life and how it was all changing so much since retirement. And at the end of the night, I guess he took pity on us, and he pulled out a wad of cash out of his pocket. It was that big, all rolled up, and he handed it to me. He said, I want you to have this, because your music, you know, is a lot better than what you're getting paid tonight. And it was just wonderful. You know, I mean, it was the biggest tip I ever got. But later on, you know, we did a selfie, and I put it on Facebook, and I said, guess who I ran into in Wisconsin, you know? And I kept getting these comments, people saying, yeah, did he give you a big tip? So apparently that was something he did with a lot of people. And just he had a great big heart, and he really believed in the music and supporting it, and he put his money where his mouth was, and also his
to fruit.
No. No.
Well, let's see what we got.
Yeah, he was just a real generous guy, you know, and he believed in the music, and he believed in supporting the music, and he did. He put his money where his mouth was, and his chocolate chip cookies, too.
Hi, Brink Brinkman here. We're just in the studio this morning doing a few demos, drinking coffee and making stuff up, and wanted to stop and do a short video to remember my friend Hagar, and I think we met back in the Frontier Ranch days. That goes back quite a ways, and we kind of hit it off right away because of Wisconsin connection. We're both cheeseheads, so, and I can remember laughing. I remember his laugh. That's what I really remember about him. He's always laughing. He's very supportive of the songs that I wrote and songwriters and the music over the years, and he never met a stranger. That's what I loved about him. And we remember him today, and I'm sure we'll remember him for days to come. So rest in peace, Hagar. We love you.
Hey, I'm Darren Vincent of Daily Invention, the Grand Ole Opry, Springer Mountain Farms. And I just wanted to tell you, when I was with the Sally Mountain Show, which is my mom and dad, Johnny and Carolyn Vincent, my sister Rhonda, and my brother Brian, we used to come to Wisconsin. And I remember Hagar would be up there and give us his, I think, half-pound chocolate chip cookies. And he just, big old round ones, and sure hate that he's passed, but I know he's up in heaven making new chocolate chip cookies for when I get up there so I can eat those. I'm looking forward to it. But sure miss him, and want to say what a memory I have when I was a kid. And sure hate that he's passed, but hope this... we'll find his family and friends in good spirits today, in celebration of his homecoming. So, farewell, and we'll see you soon, Hagar.
Hi, folks. My name is Al Widmeyer, and I'm from Goderich, Ontario, Canada. And I've been asked to say a couple of things about our good friend Hagar, who I know you are here to have a celebration of life. I first met Hagar at Bean Blossom, Indiana, Bill Monroe's Festival in 2000. And I always seen this big guy walking around, the great big red beard, and talking to everybody and everything. And so I got talking to him and told him I was from Canada. And the next thing you know, we're hanging out a wee bit. And so we was talking about beer, and he had this Wisconsin beer that he said is the best ever. And he's right. So we had, I had some beers with him, and we went and watched some shows together and went to the jams. And so that went on for a few years. And I let him park his van in my, where I camped, because I had a motor home. So he parked his van in my motor, at my, where I had my motor home. And next thing you know, a case of this beer. And then he started bringing down this cheese. So needless to say, we always had a good time with Hagar. And Then everybody used to talk about his cookies. Well, I didn't know much about the cookies. So I guess a couple of years after I met him, he gave me a poster about his famous cookies. And then I guess about the 2004, he asked for my address. And by geez, he sent me up his famous half-pound cookies. My friends were amazed. I was amazed of these half-pound cookies, and they were some good. We kept in touch just through going to different. We used to go to Spigma. We'd hook up there, and in 2006, I had the honor of playing at the Bean Blossom, Indiana, with the Dixie Flyers. And he said he used to listen to a lot of radio stations. He could the skip out of Canada, so he knew a lot of the Canadian artists, which was a very big surprise to me, being all the way down there in Indiana. But anyways, he was a really great guy. I miss him, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your celebration today. I hope this was helpful to you. But yes, he will be really missed in Canada. Have yourself a great day. Thank you.
Greetings all. Marshall Wilburn coming to you today from Virginia with fond memories of Hagar that Lynn and I have that go back to the early to mid 80s from festivals in Wisconsin and Minnesota, the IBMA in Owensboro and Louisville and Nashville, and other shows and festivals up and down the Midwest. And of course, the fondest memories of the amazing, unsurpassed, world famous, much loved, life sustaining, overnight drive sustaining chocolate chip cookies. We will indeed never forget the love and support and enthusiasm that Hagar showed the whole music community and all of us who played. And from Lynn and me, lots of love to you all.
Hi, I'm Paul Scheminger, Executive Director for the International Bluegrass Music Association. While we mourn the passing of Dave Hagar Nelson, who passed away about a month ago, really there's so much to celebrate about who he was in the bluegrass community and as a person overall. Sure, he was a bass player who got to share the stage with many greats over the years. And sure, he was affectionately known as the Cookie Man, giving out these gigantic cookies that could help sustain people over long drives in buses. He was so much more than just that Cookie Man. He was a generous soul, a philanthropist, who was known to take cash to festivals and just secretly give it to an event producer when a festival might be struggling, or give that cash to an artist because maybe he thought that artist wasn't paid quite as much as that artist might be worth. That's what he did all the time. He was a friend to so many people in our community. His generosity went even beyond that, to give away hundreds of instruments to kids who wanted to learn how to play bluegrass music. So yes, we're sad about his passing, but there's so much to be grateful for. And clearly, in our bluegrass community and the world at large, if there were more Hagars, we'd certainly be a lot better off. Thanks, Hagar.
Hi, folks. It's Doyle Lawson. And I just want to express my condolences in the loss of Hagar. Dave was a great guy, and I have great memories of when we used to first come to the Wisconsin area where I first met him, and those huge, gigantic cookies that he would bring to everybody. He's a great guy. He'll be missed.
Well, hello. This is Gil from the Old Hippie Bluegrass Show. I wanted to reach out to the family and friends of Hagar. You know, what a sad loss. The Cookie Man, the man that made some amazing half-pound cookies. The man that inspired others and left a legacy of donating instruments, of keeping bluegrass and Americana alive by getting young kids involved by giving his heart and giving all these instruments and giving his love and passion for what he really truly loved. You know, I'm very honored that he loved our show, you know, and I know he's going to be watching from heaven, and I know he's going to be making some awesome cookies up in heaven. But I wanted to reach out and thank him for being such an inspiration to us at the Old Hippie Bluegrass Show. I know Jerry feels the same way I do, you know, and we really appreciate that in this bluegrass world and Americana world for what he has done for young children and young adults by donating instruments and by showing the passion that he has and the love he has for bluegrass. I'm sorry for your loss. Rest in heaven, my brother. Peace. Thank you. This is Gil.
Hello, friends. This is Greg Cahill of Special C, and I was really sad to hear about the passing of Dave Hagar Nelson, and since I can't be with you on the celebration of his life, I just wanted to say a few words, mainly to say that I just really appreciated his friendship. We were friends for probably at least 30 years, and he was such a supporter of the music, of the musicians, of the community, and we'll really miss him. I met him years and years ago, and he was so excited about the music, and I was so happy when he started playing, because that's what he wanted to do, and I'm glad he played with Art and Art. And One year, this is many years ago, he wanted to just see what this was all about. So we took a road trip. We were in our little van, and I think we had about 10 or 12 dates, something like that. And we covered about maybe 1,500 miles. And he drove by himself, followed us every day, sometimes insisted on buying dinner for us. And he took his vacation from work, you know, and just wanted to see what this world of bluegrass touring was about. And then after that, he had such great respect, not that he didn't before, for all the musicians and the people. And he was the guy who, if you passed a pitcher for tips, he would throw in, you know, a $10 bill instead of $2 or whatever. He was just great. And then the cookies. Oh, the cookies. Yeah. We had the cookies, and over the years, of course, he improved and added the walnuts and the chocolate chips, and that was really a joy to see. I think the best day I saw him with the cookies is when he gave one to Del McCurry, and that was really something. We'll miss you, Hagar, and just salut.
Hello, this is Valerie Smith, and I'm here to talk about our friend Hagar Nelson, who we are all gonna miss so much. The thing I remember about Hagar was every time I would come to Wisconsin, usually in the dead of winter, to perform for one of Brad Cablunde's shows, he would bring sausage and cheese and crackers, along with a great big bag of his famous cookies. And the most important thing that he would also bring with that was his friendship and his smiles. I'm going to miss him so much. Hagar was such a special person and a special friend. At the end of all of my shows, I would send out a special song that I wrote about friendship, and one that he requested called Hand Me Down. So, Hagar, this is for you on your special day in memory of you, called Hand Me Down. Hand me down clothes. Hand me down shoes. I can't give you anything new. I'm not a rich girl. Here's what I'll do. I'll take this old heart and I'll hand it down to you. Mansions and silver, all shiny and new. These are the things made for the chosen few. But the things that bring me happiness aren't bought or sold in stores. They come from peace of mind and a love that's mine and yours. Oh, hand me down clothes, hand me down shoes. I can't give you anything new. I'm not a rich girl. Here's what I'll do. I'll take this old heart and I'll hand it down to you. Love you, Hagar.
Send out condolences to a great friend of bluegrass, Hagar the Cookie Man. Hagar from the old Hippie Bluegrass Show crew, Jerry Eicher here. We are going to miss you big time, buddy, in the bluegrass world. Someday when I get to heaven, I'm going to say, where's Hagar, the cookie man? I'm hungry for a cookie. God bless you and your family, Hagar, for all you've done in the bluegrass world. And like the song from Donna Ulysses says, God knows who he is.
Howdy, friends. This is David Davis, and speaking for all the Warrior River boys, let us add our condolences for Hagar Nelson. We were saddened to hear the news of his passing, and really appreciate having the opportunity to say a few words, cast a flower for him today in this service. First got to know him as Hagar when we'd be working up in the Milwaukee area or Two Rivers, Wisconsin. And he was always at the shows and always gave us a big sack of those half-pound cookies. So we enjoyed them for a long, long time. And we enjoyed his friendship. He was a great man. He enjoyed the music so much and just enjoyed musicians' fellowship. We'll miss him. Again, for all the Warrior River boys and myself, we're certainly sorry to hear the news and just really appreciative to be a part of this celebration of his life. Thank you.
Hey, this is Alan Bybee. I just want to take a moment to say how much we're going to miss our good buddy, Dave Hagar Nelson. He was a friend to all of us in Bluegrass, and I know we're all going to really miss him. And he was just always there with a friendly smile. And I tell you what, some of those cookies sure did help us make it a lot of all-night drives in Bluegrass. But rest in peace, brother. We're going to miss you. And thanks for all the memories.
Hey, here's a little song for the Cookie Man.
C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. C is for cookie, that's good enough for me. Cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C.
That stands for Cookie Man. And that's you, Hagar. We're going to miss you. Thanks for being in my life.
Hi, I'm Chris Jones. Greetings from downtown Nashville and SiriusXM Studios. I'm here doing some work. Hagar was the kind of person that made the community of bluegrass music special. But Hagar was also unique. He was one of the most uniquely generous people to be involved in the music. He was incredibly generous to artists and other people connected with bluegrass music, generous in spirit, generous financially, generous with cookies, as many of us know, sometimes with point beer, cheese, sausage, other Wisconsin products. He was just a giver, and he never expected things in return. He just loved the music. He did it for the music. I, of course, associate Hagar with Wisconsin, but I also miss him in Nashville because walking into the Sheraton Music City for the Spigma convention, I'm just used to seeing him there. And or the Station Inn in Nashville. He was a fixture there when he was in town. He was always there supporting the music. And he just gave a lot of love to bluegrass music. And we will miss him so very much.
And I'm Nate.
We're from the Bury Family Band. We always look forward to seeing Hagar at the East Troy Bluegrass Festival every year. He was a staple. Just kind of an icon for the area.
He was definitely my favorite MC at that festival. He had a super noticeable voice that you could hear all around the square, and had some very terrible jokes that everybody loved.
He always took the time to say hello and to encourage the Bury family and any other young artists that came through the contests or the band scramble or open stage, any real, just really a big supporter of the local music, definitely.
He's an encouraging spirit for sure. And he will be greatly missed by the whole Wisconsin bluegrass community.
And national, for sure.
Yeah.
We wish he could be at the gathering, but we send our thoughts and prayers to Hagar's family and friends and hope that it's a wonderful celebration of a really special life.
Thank you, Hagar, and God bless.